love Christmas. Come on, let's dance. Happy Christmas, everyone. Come join with me in a Christmas song. Happy Christmas, one and all. We'll all be merry and bright. We can play some Christmas games and dance around the tree. Twinkling lights and paper chains and lovely things to eat. Happy Christmas, everyone. Come join with me in a Christmas song. Jump for joy, Christmas time is here. For every girl and every boy, a special time of year. Happy Christmas, everyone. Come join with me in a Christmas song. Happy Christmas, one and all. We'll all be merry and bright. Happy Christmas.
Well, here we are. This is where our final clue led us. To this, the big feast.
I'm pretty good, it looks to me, too. Have you spotted the mince pies the children made?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I've got to definitely have one of those.
At feasts in olden times, they didn't used to use knives and forks. They just used their fingers.
Yeah. Like this.
Oi, come back with my chicken.
Whoa, no, I'm great now.
Have you tried the mince pies?
They're lovely.
Now, everybody, make a wish, right? Make a wish, everybody. You make a wish, too. Are you making a wish, FG? Right, don't tell me what it is. Are you all making a wish?
Yeah!
Here we go.
Oh, look down like this.
I wish for another mince pie. Oh, Chester, you've had 3 mince pies already. I love them.
Most of all of us here at Warwick Castle wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas!
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Glad tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
I've got some more wishing to do now, and that's wishing some people out there a happy birthday. And here's a very good Playdays card. Everyone's on there, including the Y Bird and Poppy and Peggy Patch too, all to wish a happy birthday to 2 young ladies. Now under there is Tess. Hello, and you're 2 years old. And under the cake there is Hetty. She knows where to be. Oh, she's on the phone. Sorry, Hetty. You're 4 years old today. Now this comes with lots and lots of love from everyone who knows you, especially your Uncle Nick. He wants to blow you a big kiss. So here it comes, girls. Big kiss for both of you. Now here is Dino the dinosaur. I think it's Dino anyway from the Flintstones, but I think he's auditioning for Joseph and his amazing colour technico. Watch out, Philip, but he's got the wrong Joseph because it's actually Joseph under there. Joseph Beestone, who's 3 years old today, and he comes from Stas. With lots of love from Mummy, Daddy and your brother Jimmy and your baby brother Charles. And you're going to have a teddy bear's picnic. Are you really going to have a picnic outside in this weather? Make sure you wrap it warm, or maybe you'll have it indoors, an indoor picnic. That's what we need this time of year. Now have a look at this. This is Santa Claus, and he's got Emily there having a go in his sack. Hello, Emily. This is with love from Mummy and Grandma, and they're sending you more love than we could fit in a lockup. Loads of love for you today. But we have a tip-top day, Emily. And here's Postman Pat, funnily enough. Wouldn't be complete without Postman Pat, would it? This is Postman Patrick, if you're not his friend. And this is Alana having a go in his car. Oh, she can't get it started. You're only two. Yes, it must be the weather. You're 2 years old today, Alana, and this is with love from Mummy, Daddy, and your sister Victoria, who was three in October. So extremely belated happy birthday to you, my dear. But Alana, it's your birthday today, and we're on time for that. So have a great time, and have a look at Thomas the Tank Engine finally getting the facelift he always wanted for Christmas. Richard, oh, that's much better looking. Richard, it's your birthday today. With love from Mummy, Daddy, and you're 3 years old. If it's your birthday today, have a fantastic time. And Williams Wish Wellingtons and Johnson and Friends are on at 1 or 2. So we will see you then. Have a good morning. Bye-bye.
This Christmas, Children's BBC will be open for business every morning. Tune in for some festive fun. We've got your favourite cartoons.
Right on, babe.
Special Christmas editions of The Movie Game and Record Breakers, and a brand new show that probes the globe.
This is the Nile. This is Ryan. And this is Global Gate Crash.
Christmas holiday mornings on Children's BBC One.
First in a triple bill of offbeat tales from a children's favourite now on BBC Two, Dr Seuss At Christmas, presented by Chuck Jones.
I first met Dr Seuss in person in about 1942 during the Second World War. I have to explain that a little bit, though, because of course, I met Dr. Seuss when my daughter was 3 or 4 years old, when she insisted upon being read to Dr. Seuss about the ooblix and the green eggs and ham and those various unsavory and very dear things that Dr. Seuss wrote. His name was Theodore Seuss Geisel. He took the name Seuss because he expected Geisel to someday write the great American novel, and he didn't want to dirty up and named Geisel, so he used his middle name, which is Seuss. He called himself Doctor for reasons unknown. He went to school at Dartmouth, and I guess some of his nuttiness have happened there. I know he told me they had a professor once there who kept a pair of huge, what we call rubbers that you put over your shoes, for rainy days, and he was sort of short-sighted. And so Dr. Seuss and a friend of his, Hugh Troy, who became a great and wonderful architect and artist, and so they got the idea of doing something with these rubbers. So they took them home one night and with oil, and took oil paints and painted them like they were huge bare feet, and in oil so that they were impervious to water. Then they covered them after they were thoroughly dry. They covered them with lamp black, which would wash off when it rained. So the next time, when the rain came, this professor put on these huge things over his huge shoes. He had pretty big feet anyway, and walked across the campus. And it was raining hard, so by and by the water did what it should do and wiped all the black off the rubbers. And there was the man with his huge bare feet walking across the campus.
It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right.
So I worked with Dr. Seuss, and we became very close friends. And then the war ended, and I went my way, pursuing my career. In 1966, I thought, well, I'd like to do something with Dr. Seuss, using his characters. So he fought me, because he had rather unfortunate experiences with Hollywood after the war. And so he fell pretty much against motion pictures in general. But I convinced him that we should, because we'd worked together before, and I felt it was right that the children should have a shot at him. So we finally agreed that we would do How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm, lighted windows below in their town.
The basic problem with any book, in putting it, particularly an illustrated book, when you're putting it on the screen is that you you have to adjust yourself to the way the artist draws. And Dr. Seuss, he draws, but he draws beautifully in his own way. The problem is, as we found out later when we did Horton Hears A Who with an elephant, at one time I made a drawing to show how he would animate, and Dr. Seuss took a look at it, and he said, that's not the way I draw the elephant. I pointed out to him, if I do it the way he did, why the bone structure in the elephant would change while he was walking, which would end up in a very gallopy, peculiar kind of a gait. So somewhere along the line, we had to be consistent in the way the character was drawn. Also, he contended at once when I started drawing the model sheets for the Grinch, well, he contended that the Grinch looked more like me than it did like his Grinch. And maybe it did, I don't know. But again, I had to make it consistent throughout the picture. And if you look at the book, you'll see there's a great deal of variation, which is fine in a book. You can get away with it. And it doesn't really matter, but it does matter in film.